they say, subspecie eternitatis. Okay. The spectacles of eternity.
Of eternity, the future.
Yeah. So those might be what might account, but obviously, it's true.
Yeah.
In fact, probably more true than you know.
Okay.
God has been especially God in keeping me because I have suffered and I'm suffering from both hypertension and diabetes since 1954. To be clear, with hypertension, 84, up to. I think regularly take my
medicine. I saw them there Monday,
Tuesday, exactly.
Discipline.
Okay. So that helps me.
Okay.
And then also I'm learning to eat less.
Okay.
Because I think food saves us, but it can endanger us.
Okay.
Especially if you don't keep within bounds.
I see.
It will follow your appetite.
So we have to discipline your appetite.
That's right. Yes.
Okay.
There is an example of my father's friend who came to work. He came often to do some labor for my father.
Okay.
And he told us a story.
Yeah.
He had a dog, a farm dog.
Yeah.
And then when he came from work and his wife gave him food, he was eating this dog. Was almost begging him for food.
Okay.
The dog was hungry, looking, sighing, wagging the tail and all that, saying really, could you give me
something to eat?
So he went and called his wife and gave her a big piece of yam to prepare food for this dog.
Yeah.
And then prepare a good sauce for him.
Okay.
And then the dog then got his choice. And ate and ate and ate until it burst.
Oh my God.
The dog burst.
Burst. And died.
Of course.
Obviously. Because of food.
Yeah. So, but this is a reality, something that really happens.
Okay, we have to control
that. Yeah, exactly. So I've made a lesson of it for myself. Then, as we say in Igbo, if someone asks you, have you eaten?
Yes.
You say, yes, I have eaten. In Igbo, have you eaten belly food?
Okay.
Well, you say, you have to say yes.
Yes, if you not.
Because if not, then you say more. Something is lacking.
Okay.
Yeah. But you can see that belly food can be. Can lead to sickness.
That's true.
So I'm no longer eating the
food. And that's the cardinal virtue, temperance.
Yes.
Exactly. Called the moderation of appetite. Thank you very much, Monsignor, for this powerful inspiration.
And, thank you for the exercise you are engaged in.
Okay.
You can see that that curiosity that you are showing.
Yeah.
And that mandate you have given yourself to realize it in the form of publication and whether in the form of books or in whatever other form. It is something that you need to create, that you have more of it among you. Because as you know, the materialism you are talking about, that is all. Not many will be doing what you are doing.
Exactly. Researching, traveling for this.
They will ask for money even to come from here to there.
Exactly.
You know?
Yes.
They would make demands.
Yes.
Fonlon.
Yes.
Was reputed, if I remember well, that he walked from the Cameroon.
Yes.
To CKC.
He walked on foot.
Good.
On foot.
Good.
It is important
to say that.
Okay.
and try and find out the distance.
Where it was long.
Yeah.
Days, the service, forest, animals.
Inter-country now.
On foot.
Good. And then when we are talking about Cameroon, yeah, it didn't start it at Ikom.
No. It started from Shisong.
Oh, good.
It's very far. It's
good.
In the northwest.
Good. So, make a point of it.
Okay.
I beg you.
So that's
make
a point
and
point.
Get that distance. And if you walked and you checked. Yes. Just as we make a point that Bishop Anyogu,
yes,
the first Igbo priest east of the Niger from Onitsha.
Yes.
And he walked, he trekked from Onitsha to Ugorji.
My God.
Yes.
Long distance.
Yes. So Fonlon from Sasson.
Sisson.
Sisson. Right.
Through
CKC Onitsha. Yes.
No, I will not doubt in mind. Yes. Thank you for reminding me of that aspect, which I took lightly.
Yeah,
okay.
You can see how early he showed interest, prowess,
yes,
defiant commitment.
Okay.
At that age.
At that age.
So what he did with his being refused the order.
Yes.
It was only a continuation. And the ease he teach, he embraced the lay life. And then saw where he could be useful,
okay,
for the community.
Exactly.
So all that, it's a man with an inspiration. And he was faithful to that.
Thank you so much, Ms. Aino.
You can say of him, he has also fought a good fight. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. And then we hope that God is crowning him to the crown of glory.
Amen. Amen. What a wonderful way to end this wonderful interview, Ms. Aino. I'm so grateful.
Thank you.
May God give you long life, good health,
thank
the realization of all your dreams, constant joy. Constant joy and happiness. Amen.
God bless.
Thank you, Master.
And now we are going from here to Mwere
to Onitsha. CKC, where Fonlon studied.
Okay.
And then to Enugu bigger.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. And then back to
God. I don't know whom you will see
in bigger.
In Onitsha. In bigger.
In Onitsha, I know Father Peter Paul Obi, who is now, who was appointed rector of Father Tansy Major Seminary.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, people you met in Rome, I suppose.
Exactly.
Okay. Now, ask to meet the oldest of them now.
Okay. Father?
Father Peter Daniel Apolloni.
Okay, you know the chat.
Yeah. He is now a professor,
okay,
in Tansy Seminary.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Interesting. Father Peter
Daniel.
Father Peter Daniel.
Patrimony A.
Yes.
A. A. K. P. U. M. O. N. U.
Okay. Apolloni.
Yeah.
He's a professor in San Tansy.
Yeah, yeah. That's the point. Let me tell you who he is.
Okay.
He trained in this Hopana seminary.
Okay.
I taught him there. And then he came to Bigard.
Yeah.
I was with him in Bigard.
Okay.
Then he went to Rome very soon. I think he must have made Brexico. There in Rome. Uh-huh. Then, when he came back after the war,
yeah,
he joined the staff of Bigard to teach.
Okay.
He studied the scripture. And eventually, he became rector of Bigard.
Oh, really?
He became rector of Bigard.
Oh,
that's what they know him for.
Okay.
Now.
I see.
Then, from Bigard, he became rector of Siwa in Port Harcourt. So all the young priests again, we had them.
Okay.
And I am sure that he has some memory
of
at least hearsay memory of Fonlon.
Okay.
So this is probably the best kind of information you can get.
Okay.
The other person
you
could ask was an excellent.
Okay.
And he is Fidelis.
Fidelis?
Eze Munari.
Fidelis Eze.
Eze E.
Yes.
M N A R I.
E-A-R-I.
Yeah, Eze Munari. M N R I.
Okay.
M N A R I.
Eze Munari.
Eze
Nari. Nari.
Okay.
Yeah. M and N are distinct.
Okay. Nari. Is he an Onitsha? He is not.
Okay.
And then, if you can't reach him, try and then talk with him.
Okay. Where is he based in Onitsha?
I wouldn't know.
Okay.
He is, he went with Tabo.
Okay.
That I mentioned, Tabo is now late.
Yes.
That former principal of CPS.
CPS.
Two of them went together to Ireland to study science. And he, they discharged him from there. He didn't continue with the history.
Okay.
As a minority.
Yes.
And when he came back, he began, he came to teach in CPS. So he's one of those good ex-seminarians and very close to the Fonlon time.
Okay. Be careful. He should be very old by now.
He should be.
In his 90s.
No. Probably not that old.
Okay.
Close.
Okay.
But then he got a big government job.
Okay.
He was in charge of the Ajokuta steel factory. Remember, the biggest steel making industry in Nigeria.
Yes.
Is in Ajokuta.
Yes, true.
Yes. He was in charge. He was the general manager. Yeah.
That's
so until there was a coup, and then they took him out of it and locked him up because he was a new man.
Okay.
He should not have aspired that. So that's as a matter. Try and get to talk with him, even if you don't see him.
Yes.
Try and get his number.
No, I will try.
And then go ahead with contacting him, either physically or you can talk with him.
Thank you so much, my friend. I will make sure I'll extend your greetings to Father Peter.
Right.
I will tomorrow.
Exactly.
Thank you so much, one more.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.